Did you know that a single biological process is related to diseases as diverse as diabetes, Parkinson's, and cancer? The process is called the unfolded protein response, or UPR, and it helps cells deal with problematic proteins. Proteins play many key roles in the cell, including on the cell surface, where they help the cell communicate with other cells in the organism. Proteins can only do their jobs if they are the correct shape, which scientists refer to as being properly folded. Sometimes, though, they don't fold correctly and instead behave kind of like floppy, sticky spaghetti noodles. The UPR deals with troublesome unfolded proteins in an internal chamber called the endoplasmic reticulum, or ER. The ER serves many functions. Most importantly, it's where newly made proteins fold. It also serves as a quality control center, kind of like a TSA agent at the airport. If the new proteins are in good shape, they're allowed to go on to their destinations. If they're unfolded, the ER sends them to be degraded so they don't gum up the works. When a cell produces lots of unfolded proteins, the UPR kicks in. Peter Walter at UC San Francisco discovered a critical sensor protein called IRE1 that detects when the unfolded protein level is too high and tells the cell that it needs to make more ER. Even with this extra boost, the ER can get overwhelmed and accidentally allow unfolded proteins to go through the quality check, which would cause devastating problems. In these cases, the UPR tells the cell that time has run out and makes it self-destruct so it doesn't hurt the whole organism. So how does the UPR relate to diabetes, Parkinson's, and cancer? The cells that metabolize sugar need to produce lots of insulin, which must be folded in the ER. But sometimes the ER can't handle this load and the UPR kills these important cells, which can lead to diabetes. Parkinson's and many other neurodegenerative diseases are associated with extreme unfolded protein levels, which may prompt UPR-initiated cell death in the brain. And in cancer, tumor cells can hijack the UPR to make more ER, which helps them grow more quickly. Scientists are working to understand exactly how IRE1 and the other UPR components work so they can harness them to regulate the UPR. Figuring out that piece of the puzzle could be a key to treating or even curing these diseases and more.